What do you think about stem cell research?
What do I think about stem cell research? I think it holds huge possibilities for medical breakthroughs.
Stem cell research. Let's see. I'm for it. I think that, generally speaking, it's going to increase the odds that we can solve a lot of mankind's problems. Maybe even cancer. Who knows? Maybe we can grow another organ if one of our organs fails. There's a lot of good things I think will come from it.
Stem cell research has a lot of potential. There are some questions there that have to be figured out, some ethical ones, but I think by and large, I would more favor it than, although I still think there are a lot of potential misuses.
I think it's interesting. I'm not sure how ethical it is. You know, my general guideline when it comes to using genetics and modifying genetics, bioengineering, is if it can help for the greater good of humankind without hurting or perhaps changing too much the way things are naturally, then it's good. I think stem cell research is a little tricky. I'm generally for the research part of it, but I'm not sure how much should be applied to humans.
Yes, I think absolutely it's the right thing to do. There are absolutely no solid arguments of any kind against it.
Yes, okay, but what about these religious arguments? Are people against stem cell research? Do you think their arguments are valid?
I'm a religious school, I've done that. I don't believe that God created man. I think man created God. So, in that perspective, I don't have a problem with
it. As long as we're not making a whole human, actually genetically engineering a human, then I don't have a problem with it.
Okay.
I definitely see the points. I like to think of myself as being pretty open-minded and willing to accept science. But I do think that we have to look very carefully at the ethical issues around stem cell research.
Not kidding.
It gives me pause. It makes me think, and that's why I don't sort of immediately say yeah, let's do it. But on the other hand, this whole thing about when you're actually killing something. I'm not enough of a scientist to know details in that, and I'm just not sure anybody can. I don't know. It gives me pause. It makes me stop and think. But I'm not. It doesn't automatically rule it out because I don't know enough about it.
No, because they're not people.
Yeah.
They're cells. Does your skin cell have a right?
No. Yeah. Some people argue that because it's a living organism.
But then they eat cheese.
Yeah.
They,
precisely.
No, the arguments have no. There's no logical foundation for them. I think honestly, it would be problematic to say. I think you have a moral obligation to use these treatments because if you can stop diseases, if you can save people's lives with stem cell therapies, and you don't do it,
who's the one who's wrong?
Yeah, you're committing a sort of essentially moral hypocrisy right there.
Okay, so how about GMOs or genetically modified organisms?
You've got to understand, for that going into food, right?
Yeah.
Is that the attitude? There's a couple of things you got to understand. Right now, it's already in our food. We are facing a situation where our population is going up exponentially. And we need to double our food production in the coming years or we're in trouble.
Mm-hmm.
The only way we think right now, our best alternative, is probably genetic alteration of food.
I don't mind eating genetically. I don't really have a problem with genetically engineered wheat, for instance. We have there's going to be 10 million people in the world, or even more, within decades. So obviously we need to meet the food needs of that population.
I guess it'd be the same thing. you know, there's a possibility that
the use of it.
The use of it. It's how, what sort of organism are you going to produce? What are they going to do?
I, again, think that we are morally obligated to use GMOs.
If it feeds people, for example.
Well, not just feeding people.
Like,
right?
Saving lives.
Saving the environment, saving the number of lives, for example, particularly in agriculture.
And how about GMOs or genetically modified organisms? What's your stance on those?
Right. Well, again, I mean, if they're genetically modified organisms, if they're sort of simple organisms to the benefit of mankind, then I think that's a positive.
So what do you think about this whole tomato thing in China about splicing human DNA with tomato DNA? You're not...
No, I don't think that's a good idea.
I don't know a lot about it. I mean, certainly you got to be careful with that. There was a belief that the Jakob Creutzfeldt disease, the human brain wasting, was associated with people eating, you know, cannibalism. And, you know, cows, when they had mad cow disease, was because they ate other cows. I mean, that was never, nothing concrete has been proven. They did take steps where they banned that, certainly.
I don't know what to make of that. I hadn't heard about it. That's new. But news to me. But I don't know what to say. It depends on what sort of genes are being spliced. Is that the gene that makes the tomato human? Then I wouldn't eat tomatoes, I suppose. But
I would eat one of the tomatoes, let's just put
that. Human?
Yeah, great.
DNA?
Go for it. Know why?
Why?
What's the argument against it? Let me ask you that first.
Yeah, no.
It makes tomatoes immune to insects, right?
Yep.
Yeah.
No, not insects.
Well,
viruses that kill.
Viruses, yeah.
So, do you think that genetic engineering is a necessary advancement for our future? Do you think it's a necessary technological advancement?
Yes. Yeah.
Is it necessary? I know that we have benefited greatly from it. I would like to think that we could come up with solutions without having to change nature too much. But I also recognize that as human beings, we have impacted this earth far beyond any other living organism, and we need to take steps to remedy that. And that might be biogenetic engineering.
Isn't that in part?
Yeah.
Or is this just another... Is this using technology...
Properly.
Yeah. Is the main purpose here to make money for yourself?
Or is it really beneficial?
And, you know, I think it's gonna be, I don't
want to
be around when all of a sudden
tomatoes
start talking to you.
Yeah, I think it is. I think it really is. I think it's important. This is sort of the next step. I mean, imagine being able to eliminate diseases and not having to treat them. Imagine being able to eliminate some of the major sources of pollution that we have. Better yet, imagine being able to engineer bacteria that consume waste.
So genetic engineering is a process where the recombinant DNA technology is used to introduce desirable traits into organisms. You could think of this as selective breeding, but with genes. And a genetically engineered creature, or a GMO, is where they take one creature and then they introduce another creature's or another organism's DNA. An example would be the liger, or the crops they make where they introduce other organisms' DNA, such as human DNA, in the tomatoes to create tomatoes that don't need pesticides. One of the ethical considerations people have to think about when they think about genetic engineering is that in the natural world, organisms develop specific desirable traits through evolution, such as camouflage or poison tips. And by messing around with their DNA, we're creating these hybrid creatures that don't exactly function properly. For example, the liger. And a lot of people, like the eco corporation Greenpeace, think that this is wrong because we're messing around with nature. And normally evolution takes a long process because nature is perfecting and finding out what's best for the creatures. By creating these hybrids, we're messing around with nature and could lead to irreversible consequences for the environment. I think before we continue creating new creatures and creating hybrids, we need to first understand what we're doing before we continue to pursue this.
Okay, so the liger is a crossbreed between the lion and the tiger. It weighs about 1,200 pounds. Basically, if you get pounced on by that, you're pretty much dead. The weird thing about the liger is they get the worst traits of each one. And it's even weirder because the liger likes to swim, which is, you know, pretty unlikely. And another flaw in there, so they cannot live in the environment with other lions.
Another thing about ligers is because they're infertile, the only way to create a liger is, again, breeding a lion with a tiger. So this shows that nature doesn't want it to happen. That's why the males are sterile and the females aren't very fertile. Also, ligers are much more susceptible to disease. And in all honesty, instead of wasting our resources in creating ligers, while I say ligers are very beautiful creatures, the thing about them is that, honestly, they're taking up a lot of resources and spaces in zoos and other areas where we could be using the money to actually protect endangered species or breed animals that are dying out. So I think that instead of creating animals just for photo ops and money, we shouldn't be doing that. Cloning is the creation of an organism that is an exact genetic copy of another. Basically, it means that both the organisms have exactly the same DNA. And they do this by using petri dishes and they artificially fertilize the egg. And an example of cloning would be Dolly the sheep, who was cloned in 1997. And the sheep lived for 6 years and then it died. Honestly, I don't think we need to pursue cloning because we already lived in an overpopulated world and we don't need to recreate or waste our resources on recreating the same type of creatures that will be inferior and are normally killed because they don't live up to people's standards. Also, clones live the fraction of the original creature's lifespan and they normally are really susceptible to diseases and they are much smaller and honestly, cloning doesn't really benefit anyone.
So my opinion is I have to agree with Paloma. The fact is, we're not ready for cloning. We don't know how to do it. I mean, with all these vulnerabilities and in light of them, we don't know how to do this quite yet. And why should we start messing with it when we don't have a full understanding?